So what are the essential elements of the fast? What we call arkan as-sawm. We have two essential elements. Number one, to abstain from those acts that break the fast from dawn to sunset. So no food, no drink, no fulfillment of any sexual desire. The second element is the intention, the niyyah. You must have the niyyah that you are going to fast. Some people are of the opinion that you do it every day. Every evening I am saying, tomorrow inshallah I'm going to fast. And another opinion says, if you are going to fast Ramadan, you have the intention, the niyyah of fasting the whole month, then may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it in this way. So who is obliged to fast? According to the majority of the scholars, you have to be a sane Muslim, adult, not traveling, and for women, she has to be pure, clean from childbirth, bleeding, or the monthly period. You have to be healthy. So if you are an adult, Muslim, healthy, sane, not traveling, not on a journey, suffering from any illness which would prevent you from fasting, then you are obliged to fast. And here we're talking about the fast of Ramadan here. Some people are allowed not to fast, but they must pay a ransom. So those who are permitted not to fast, but must pay a ransom for not fasting. Anyone who is chronically ill, anyone not expected to recover, and they cannot fast at all during any time of the year, whether it's winter or summer, old people, frail people, people who are doing a very hard job and they cannot, there is no other job but that one, and they cannot fast. So these people are allowed not to fast, but they must pay a ransom. They must feed a number of poor people equivalent to the number of days they couldn't fast. And if they haven't got the means, then they don't do it. So the first group, those who are permitted not to fast, but must pay a ransom for not fasting. The second group, those who are permitted not to fast, but later they must make up the days they missed. This is someone is temporary ill, not chronically ill, temporary illness, or someone on a journey. So when they are back home, they have to make up the days they missed. And when this person, the one who's not feeling well, he will recover, then he must make up the days he missed. And the third group, those who must not fast and must make up the missed days. We are talking about women who are having their period or post-childbirth bleeding. They are not allowed to fast. They will have to make up the days later, and they don't pay a ransom for the days they couldn't fast, because if they are healthy, they don't do that. So the first group, those who are permitted not to fast, but must pay a ransom for not fasting. This applies to the people who are chronically ill, people who cannot fast at all, at any time of the year. And the second group, those who are permitted not to fast, but later they must make up the days they missed, someone who's on a journey or someone who's not well. And the third group, those who must not fast and must make up the missed days. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفروه إنه غفور رحيم. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا آمنا بما أنزلت واتبعنا الرسول فاكتبنا مع الشاهدين. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا، أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اشف مرضانا، اللهم اشف مرضانا، اللهم ارحم موتانا، اللهم ارحم موتانا، اللهم اقض الدين عن المدينين، وفرج هم المهمومين، ونفس كرب المكروبين، وفك أسر المأسورين. وصلي اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والعصر، إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.